I think what all of this talk today about the electronic medical record, meaningful use, et cetera, is a discussion about medicine. The idea of the use of tools in the practice of medicine is not a new idea. And one of the stories that we like to call on when physicians or any others are concerned about that this is in some way no longer the mainstream of what we do, there was an outcry in at the turn of this last century with the implementation of a stethoscope. There was an outcry saying this was a horrible miscarriage, that this was interfering with the contact between the patient and the physician, that these instruments were the tools of the devil, they should be eradicated immediately. Well, if you went up to any physician today and said that the stethoscope that he has around his or her neck is an instrument of the devil, they'll probably walk away laughing. Just as those days, that was a traumatic change for our profession, the use of information systems, computers, in the practice of medicine has been traumatic. The evolution, however, of our understanding that they are incredible instruments that can allow us to not only probe new information, have it available right at the point of care, and not only extend our capabilities in terms of diagnosis and treatment, but make up for any deficiencies or problems that we have in terms of availability of the necessary information just in time for the best care that we can deliver to our patients. And I haven't met a physician that doesn't want to deliver the best care he or she can to their patients. The use of the information tools that we now have available to us, and everything from little handheld devices in our phones to pads to our computers, are so vital to obtaining the necessary information, not to provide just adequate care or cross-check some drug interactions. All of that's important, but in fact can make the difference between a life that's essentially destroyed and one that can be incredibly productive and normal. One of the things that that in the very recent past I was involved with was an asthma disease management program wherein the patient has to engage with not only compliance, which is really a dirty word for a lot of folks because it implies that I just tell you what to do and you just need to do it and that's all, but rather for the patient to engage in measurement of actually evaluating how they're doing and watching to see which stimuli and which events actually perturb their breathing, and then keep track of that and either avoidance or modification of their diet, lifestyle, or what have you in order to improve their health. The idea of a patient having devices now that can be used through their iPhones and actually record all of that information and then automatically transmit it to the physician. The idea that if they're having an acute attack, they can have a virtual telemedicine visit with any clinician, nurse or doctor in real time. These are not fantasy stories. These are happening today. And the notion of saying, well, I mean, rather than tethering me and letting me live my life, these new information tools can allow me to be in better control and actually communicate with what I need, when I need it. These aren't stories that are science fiction and someday it's happening right now. Participation in one's own health, participation in one's own care, transmuting the American model of saying, me doctor, you patient, and therefore I have all the knowledge and you just come in because I have that, is archaic, is out of date, and not only that, but we are ending up spending more money than almost every other country, civilized or otherwise, on the planet, and getting much less for it. We have to think different. We have to use our brains in order to get out of this rut we're in with regards to more care is not better care. And last but not least, I think the American public and the medical profession is realizing that no one has the corner on information. It really needs to flow. It needs to be ubiquitous. It needs to be something that the patient can access as easy as the physician, and hopefully better educate themselves as to how to help themselves better, because they're 7x24x365. We're together for an hour every 5 weeks. that physicians are not trained in medical school in detail in the use of these devices is unfortunately still more common than not, so that's one problem. But the other is that if we belittle the importance of this incorporation of these information tools into the armamentarium of medical practice, then we continue to make physicians feel, yeah, this is below me. This really should be my clerical staff, somebody else, anybody else but me. While in fact, quite the opposite is the case. When for example, a drug interaction is a potential in ordering a list of medications as I'm ordering, why wouldn't I want to know that before I finish writing or typing in the information for ordering those medicines? Why would I want to wait to see what happens with a patient? What if there is a reaction that occurred 10 years before you forgot, but the record is there to be used for safety and quality? What if there's new information about diagnosis or treatment that is superior to what my routine had been? And because of my poor memory, I didn't remember everything about that every single time. Physicians know they're human too. With these tools, we can basically transfer medicine from anecdote, from memory dependent, to latest care, safe care, and hopefully, God willing, go to the next level and saying, this is where we really do need research and new science applied.